Okay, so we'll continue with our main. Okay, so now we have configure retention policy to redundancy. So here in retention policy you can set two types. One is redundancy and one is recovery windows. What is the recovery windows and what is the, you got to know the redundancy, right? If more than one copy, the previous backup will be obsolete. That is the redundancy. And the recovery window is, so few company will have 1 week of recovery windows. Seven days. So you have to retain last 7 days backup. If you set the recovery windows of 7 days, you need to set last 7 days of backup, right? So suppose that you have taken the backup on 1st Fifth, or let's say that recovery window is 7 days. Oh, sorry, 15 days. I want to set the recovery window of 15 days. So I need to recover the database since last 15 days. So I have taken the backup on 1st, 5th, 7th, 10th. 15. Okay, we have taken the backup on this date. Okay, now recovery window is 7 days, so 15 days. Okay. So if you set the recovery window of 15 days, so we need to retain last 15 days backup, right? Last 15 days backup we need to retain. Okay, so 15 days backup means till 5th, right? From 5th, we need the backup from 5th, right? Today date is 20th, we have taken the backup today. So your recovery window is 15 days, so you have to retain the backup from 20 minus 15 from 5th, 5th of January, you can assume. This is January, so from till from 5th of January he have to retain all his backups. Here we have taken backup on 15 days. Means you have to must have the backup from 5th of January, right? So that you must have backup from 5th of January, and before 5th January backup, the backup is not required because that is not under recovery windows. Company has set the policy that I want to recover the database since last 15 days, point in time recovery. Means I want to, you can also go back to the database, previous point in time. So company has policy that I want to recover the database since last 15 days. So you must have the backup for last 15 days, right? If you have only this backup, you cannot recover, you cannot go back to the previous point in time. If you have only 20th backup, okay. So if you want to go previous point in time, you must have the backup of 5th January. Then you can go to the database till 5th January. Okay. But it's not like that. Only backup from 5th January will be retained. It depends when you have taken the backup. Okay, so recovery window you have set 15 days. So from which date backup is required now? Backup is required from which backup is required now? The recovery window is 15 days. So company might ask you to recover the database for 18th, 12th, 8th, 5th, anything. Okay. They can say you anything because recovery window is 15 days. So which all backups are required? Any idea? So the maximum recovery window is 15 days. So you can maximum go to till 5th of January. Company may ask you to recover the database till 5th of January. So which backup is required if you want to recover the database to 5th of January? Any idea, anyone? I want to recover the database till 5th January. So which backup is required?
Third?
Yes, third backup is required because we need the third backup. The company has set the policy 15 days. So I can go to the database till 5th. You have to go to the database till 5th. But if you want to go to the database till 5th of January, then you need this backup. You need this backup, right? Without this backup, you cannot go to the database till 5th of January. Why? If you don't have all these backups, with the help of 20th backup, you cannot go to the previous point in time, right? You have the backup till 20th, so you can get the data. Whatever changes made since backup 20th. Okay, if you delete all these backups, then you can recover the database till 15th. Okay, so we need this backup, third backup, full backup. So what we can do? We have taken the backup on 3rd. So we can restore. All these are not required. All these backups are not required now. I want to go to the previous point in time. Okay. Till 5th January. So all these are not required now, but company may ask you anything, recover the database till anything between this date. Now I want to recover the database on 3rd, then this on 5th, then 3rd backup is required. So you have to restore the backup, and what you need to do, you need to apply the changes whatever they made from 3rd to 5th. Okay, from 3rd to 5th, you have not taken backup, right? So you need to recover the database. How? Using archive log file. So whatever the changes are made, we need to apply those changes from the archive log file. So even though if you set the recovery window 15 days, it will retain the backup more than 15 days. It depends when you have taken the backup. Okay. So assume that we have taken the backup on 5th. You have taken the backup on 5th. Then this time only 15 days backup is retained, because you have already taken the backup on 5th, and one backup is there also on 3rd. This time this backup is not required, because we already have the backup. Why we need? We don't need this, right? So it depends when you have set the recovery windows. When you have taken the backup, it depends on that. So this is the recovery windows. And this is a configure max set size unlimited. So whenever you are taking the backup, the backup will be taken in the backup set. So what is the backup set? You need to understand these two things, backup set and backup is. Backup set and backup is. Backup set is the logical. Whenever you take a backup, it will create a backup set. Okay, so whenever you are taking any backup, then it will create the backup set, and for the database there will be one backup set, for control file, SP file, one backup set, archive log file, one backup set. So if you want to take the backup of the database plus archive log file, then it will create the backup set, different backup set. Backup set for data files, backup set for control file and SP file, backup set for archive log file. Okay, so three backup set will be created if you want to take the backup of database, including control file and SP file and archive log file. Three backup set will be created, and in this backup set, for data files backup set, 10 data files will be stored in each backup set. In each backup set of data files, 10 data files will be stored, not more than that. So if we have 11 data files, then it will create two data file backup set. Okay, so in one backup set, 10 data files will be retained. And what about the backup pieces? Backup pieces is the physical. Okay, this is the logical and this is the physical. So here, each backup set will have one backup piece at least. Each backup set at least one backup piece. So physically, this backup piece will be stored in that location. Okay, so this backup set 10 data files. 10 data files backup will be stored in the operating system, right? So that is called the backup set. Backup piece. But one backup set can have multiple backup pieces. Okay, you can divide into multiple pieces. Okay, so 10 data files, you can assign multiple backup pieces. Minimum is one, but maximum no limit. You can divide into pieces. This backup set you can divide into multiple pieces to store in the database. Okay, so this is the backup set and backup pieces. And here we have max set size, backup set. So you can also set the maximum backup set size. Okay, one backup set size must be how much? If you set the 10 GB, then in one backup set, only 10 GB will be retained. Means, suppose that you have set max set size 10 GB. Now your data file size is, you have 4 data file size, 5 GB, data file number 2, 5 GB, 5 GB, 5 GB each, number 3, 5 GB, suppose that we have a 4 backup set. Okay, we have 4 data files and maximum backup set size you have mentioned 10 GB. So in this backup set, one backup set, how many data files will be retained? Maximum set backup set size you mentioned 10 GB. So one backup set, two data files,
right?
This time there won't be 10 data files because you said the maximum set size only 10 GB. So only two data files will be retained. Data file 1 or 2, any two data files will be retained. So it will create two backup set, right? If you're taking the backup of data files, all data files, it will create two backup set. Okay, two files. In each backup set will have two files and two backup pieces will be created. But if you are setting the maximum set, you cannot set the maximum set size less than 5 GB. 4 GB you cannot do like that. You cannot do 4 GB. Why? Because one data file will be part of only one backup set. One data file will be part of one backup set. It cannot be splitted into multiple backup set. Okay, it's not like that. You can, if the data file size is 5 GB, then this 5 GB data file will be part of only one data file, data backup set. It won't create in this data, won't be part of two backup sets. Okay. So this data file will not be divided into two backup sets. It will be written in the in one backup set only. So maximum set size is 4 GB. So can you take the backup now? You cannot take, right? You set the max set size 4 GB. How can you take the backup? Because one data file size is 5 GB. So this data file cannot be fit in this maximum in this backup set. So you will get the error. So while setting the maximum set size, we have to check the biggest data file size. Okay, so biggest data file size is 5 GB. So we set 5 GB. If there is 10 GB, you need to set 10 GB. So suppose that this data file size is 10 GB. You need to set the max set size 10 GB. Otherwise, your backup will fail. Okay. Why? Because you will take the backup of max set two data files. Okay. If you set 5 GB here, in case of 10 GB, if you set 5 GB here, then you can take this backup of this data file. This data file also you can take. This data file also you can take. But what about this? You cannot take the backup of this data file. So you will get the error. Okay. So this is a maximum set size. You need to set, you need to check the biggest data file size. Okay, and if the data file size is huge, like data file size is like 200 GB, then what we are going to do? Data file size is 200 GB. Then what we are going to do? We can do, you can divide this data file size in 4 pieces. Okay, you can divide this data file size in 4 pieces. Backup set will be 1. Backup set will be 1. but backup is will be 4. Okay, there will be 4 physical location. It will create 4 backup pieces, but backup set will be 1. Okay, so if you want to speed up the Armin backup, you can divide this backup into 4 parts and you can add number of processes. So your backup speed will be faster, but it will be stored in the 4, it will create 4 backup pieces. So this is a backup set and backup pieces. Okay, so now I will show you few reporting reporting. Now how to take the backup? If you want to take the backup of database, just type backup database. Okay, so I will set the configure control file auto backup on. I want to take the backup of database and control file and archive log files, everything. So just type backup database. If you type backup database, only data files will be taken the backup. Data files and control file, because auto backup is on. So I want to take the backup of data files and archive log files, control file as well. So backup database plus archive log. Okay, so while using Armin, your database must have to be in the archive log mode. So you can see that it's showing that database in the no archive log mode. So first make the database in archive log mode. Shut immediate. Startup mount alter database archive log. Alter database. Okay. Okay. Now connect with the Armin target. Connect with the target database. Backup database plus archive log. So you can see here. These data files are taken backup. System, syscall, Kundo, and users. Okay, so now we have taken the backup. So you can see here, okay, so it's going to different location. So this flash recovery area is not set, and so default it will be stored in this backup location. So before taking the backup, set the flash recovery area. Backup is taken, it is stored in this location. Okay, so how to set the flash recovery area? So if you want to set the flash recovery area, just type alter system set db recovery file dest. First set the size db recovery file destination size, means how much size you want to assign for backup. 400 4000 MB means 4 GB. Scope equal to, now alter system set db recovery file list. So we have created a folder, which one? Disk one prod FRA, right? Disk one prod FRA, we have created the folder. So I am going to store all backup files in this location. Scope equal to both. Okay. Not type arc, go to the argument target. How to check the backup which you have previously taken? List backup. So you can see here. Now I am going to delete this backup. I am going to take press backup. Now list backup. If you want to check the backup, just type list backup. You will get all backups information. Now take the backup or backup database plus archive log. Okay, so you can see here the backup has been taken and where it is stored. This archive log file backup is stored in this location, Dev backup set. This is the location for archive log file. Okay, and for backup and for data and data file backup, this is the location, this is the backup piece. So these four data files, one backup piece. For control file we'll have one more backup piece. See, we have one more backup piece for control file. So how to take back, how to check the backup? List backup. So you can see how many backup set has been created. Backup set number 5, this is one backup set. This is the archive log file backup set, and you can see the sequence number which is stored in this backup, in this backup set. So all these archive log files are stored in the backup set number 5, and backup set number 5, and where it is stored. This backup set is stored in this location, disk 1 prod FRA location. This is the physical location for this backup set, for all these archive log. And backup set number 6, in the 6th backup set we'll have 4 data files, you can see here. Because we have only 4 data files, so all data file is part of only one backup set. And where it is stored? It is stored in this location. And number 7 also, it is storing the one backup, one archive log file, sequence number 18. So in one archive it is storing 17 4 to 17 is storing, getting stored in this backup set 5. So one archive log file is getting stored in other backup set, you can see here. And this is for control file and SP file. There is one more backup set for control file and SP file. If you want to check the backup location, go to this, go to the operating system log. So this is the backup location. You can see here archive log file auto backup location. Auto backup is the backup for control file and SP file. And data file backup and archive log file backup will be stored in this backup set folder. Okay. And it will generate the data also. So there are 3 backup set, 2 backup set for archive log and 1 for data file. And the control file backup is stored in this auto backup location. There are 4 backup set has been created. Okay, so this is how you can check the backup. Now just have list backup summary. So you will get only backup summary. How many backup sets are there? And each backup set will have a tag. You can see here. Each backup set will have a tag. So there are 4 backup sets. I want to check the backup of only data file. So just type list backup of database. So you will get only backup of data files. You can see here, if you type backup of database, and where the backup of data files are stored, in this location. I want to check the backup of archive log file. So list backup of archive log. archive list list backup of all archive log. All right, archive okay, so just type list archive log all. List archive log all. Then you will get it. No, this is actually archive log location. List backup of archive log okay, just type list backup of archive log from which sequence number you want to get the archive log file backup. So just type from the sequence number 1 or whatever it is. So you will get all the backup of archive log file from that sequence number. Now I want to check the backup of a particular data file. So how to check if the particular data file is in has been taken in a backup or not. So list backup of data file 1. You can see the data file 1 backup has been taken and this is the location and this is the backup set. And backup of control file, if I want to check the backup of the control file. So list backup of control file. Backup of control file and SP file location will be the same. It will be stored in the same backup. Now we have obsolete backup. What is obsolete backup? Obsolete backup is depend on the retention period. Retention period and recovery windows. Retention period of redundancy or recovery windows. So as I mentioned earlier, if you set the recovery windows for 15 days, all old backup will be marked as obsolete because it's not required for the recovery purpose. Previous backup will be marked as obsolete backup. Okay, which is not required for the recovery purpose. So here we have redundancy 1. We have set the redundancy 1 means only one backup will be retained. And if you take the, I have already taken the backup. Now once I take the new backup, previous backup will be marked as obsolete. So now again I am taking the backup. Data file 1 backup already has been taken, right? Again I am taking. Again I am taking the backup of data file 1. So there are two backups. One is previously we have taken and one is the new one. So previous backup is not required because redundancy 1. But here you will have two backup, right? Backup of this data file we have two. So previous backup for this data file will be marked as obsolete. List obsolete.
Subhas, what is one?
Data file number one. So each data file will be assigned with the serial number 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, you can get it from the V$ data file view. What is the serial number for the data file? System data file will have the serial number 1. Sys of data file will have the serial number 2. So you can see here earlier we had taken the backup, right? And this archive log files, we have taken the backup db form_run. Okay, so backup we have already taken for archive log file earlier. Okay, so it is marking as obsolete backup. We have already taken earlier, so all these backup are obsolete, previous backup. Now this data file is now, this is a data file backup, this is now obsolete.
Where you can see that is mark is obsolete?
Where we can see,
yeah.
If you type a report obsolete, you will get all obsolete backup, means no longer required for the recovery. Okay, if you have put in the backup, if you have the repeated file, then previous backup will be marked as obsolete backup because it's not longer required for the recovery. So you can delete obsolete backup. Yes. Now just have list backup. And report obsolete. You know obsolete. Again, if you take the backup, so for that backup database, then previous backup will show as obsolete backup because we have recent backup. So previous backup will be marked as obsolete because redundancy is set to 1, so we can retain only one backup, not more than one. So if you have most recent backup, then previous backup will be obsolete. Okay, now if you can type a report, this auto backup, this control file back auto backup will be taken automatically. So control previous control file backup will be obsolete also. So you can see here, this archive log file backup, all these backups are backup pieces are obsolete now. Okay, all these are obsolete because we have already taken the backup all these files. And this obsolete backup means if you have the obsolete backup, you can recover the database using that backup. It's not like that, you cannot recover the database. You can recover the database using obsolete backup, but there is no guarantee. This obsolete backup will be deleted automatically. If you don't have a space, more space in this flash recovery area, the obsolete backup will be deleted automatically. It will get deleted. Okay, if there is no space. Okay, if you don't delete also. So you need to delete this obsolete backup, will not be deleted automatically if we have enough space. So you need to manually you have to delete it. Okay, so delete all delete obsolete backup. Okay, so this backup has been deleted. And there is something called expired backup. What is expired backup? Expired backup is whenever you are taking the backup, when you have taken the backup and the backup has been deleted, this obsolete backup has been deleted automatically, right? It will get deleted automatically. So once it is deleted, then now it will be expired backup. The obsolete backup will be changed to the expired once it is deleted. But also if someone has deleted the backup manually, like someone has deleted the backup, ctprod, okay, so suppose that this backup got deleted manually, someone has deleted this backup. Now this will become expired backup. If someone has deleted the backup manually, now it will be expired. But how can you get the expired backup? List expired backup. Now you cannot get. Till now you are not getting the expired backup because Oracle is not aware that someone has deleted the files from the operating system level. So for that you have to use cross check backup. And then just have list expired backup. Okay, so you can see here this data files, this backup set has been deleted physically. So now these are expired backup, and this expired backup you cannot use because the backup is not available, right? So you cannot use this expired backup. Obsolete backup you can use, but expired backup you cannot. So this is a difference between obsolete backup and expired backup. Now just type delete expired. Delete expired backup. Okay, now we have deleted the expired backup. And report need backup. So how to know which file has not been taken backup? So report need backup. So we have deleted one backup, right? Which we have taken. So you will get this, all this data for data file 1, 2, 3, 4, there is no backup of this data files, right? From where it will take the information? How Oracle is saying that these files are need to be taken backup? It depends on the retention and redundancy. Okay, if you said you have said the redundancy 1, so in backup you must have at least one copy of the data file, one backup file. So in the backup is, in the backup we don't have any backup, right? So you can get this information that you need to take this backup of this data file. Archive log file we have the backup, but for this data file we don't have. So you need to take the backup of this data file. You just type backup database. Now just type report need backup. Now everything has been taken backup. It is meeting the retention period, retention and redundancy. Okay. And we have the v$view also. Using v$view you can get the information of the backup. So if you want to take the, if you want to check the backup files, which files have been in backup, you have taken the backup, you can go to the SQL prompt, type select star from v$backup files. So whatever the files has been taken backup, you can get it. $ select if name so you can see here this is the backup files, and this backup, these files are stored in this backup location. You can get the information of backup set $backup set. So select p he says select you can when you have taken when you have started the backup also you can get it when the backup has been completed you can also get it using v dollar backup set okay so you can get it all the information of the backup set and read all of file backup you can get it from this view sp file backup okay admin configuration you can get it in this view $rn So you can set, you can get all admin, whatever you have made the changes, you will get it. So we have made these changes, backup optimization of default device type disk and control file backup, auto backup on. So whenever you are making changes, it will be updated in this $rmin configuration. And which you have not made any changes, that you cannot see here. And if the backup is corrupted, also you can get the information if any backup is corrupted. Select the from $rmin backup corruption. They know backup is not corrupted. Okay, if any backup is corrupted, you can also get it. And we have from 11G we have the validate the database if any block is corrupted you can also validate using rmin just type validate database Connect with the admin target. Okay. Here the database is not started. So admin target connected with the dev database and just type validate database. It will validate all database, all data files. If any block is corrupted, any file is missing. So it will validate all data files. If any block is corrupted, you can get it. If any block is corrupted, you can get it from this. Here you can get it. So you can see here, you are validating the database. File status mark corrupt empty blocks block exempt. Okay, this is a block type data blocks failing. block processed, there are no failing blocks. You can see the empty blocks, blocks is mined. Okay. So there are no corrupted blocks. You can also validate the backup. Validate the database backup database. Okay, so tomorrow I will show you recovery, how to perform the restore recovery in different scenarios. Okay, so that I will show you tomorrow. Okay, any doubt anyone? And incremental backup also I will show you tomorrow. What is incremental backup and how to take it. Okay, so we'll meet tomorrow. Okay. Bye everyone.
Bye.